Now we'll study about the magnetic effects of electric current. In previous sections, we have studied about heating effect of electric current. Similar to that, when electric current is passed through a metal wire, it produces magnetic effects. Here we can write about it that when electric current is passed through a wire, it behaves like a magnet. This is called magnetic effect of electric current. This we can understand with the help of a realistic experiment. Here you can see in this experiment, we are using a solenoidal coil which is wound over a metal rod. On the two ends of this coil are connected with a battery via a bulb and a switch. Here you can see when the switch is closed, the bulb glows, which indicates that a current is flowing through the wire. And when the switch is in off position, the current stops. Now to detect the magnetic effect produced by this solenoidal coil, we place a compass needle in front of this iron rod on which the solenoid wire is wound. Here again, if we perform the experiment by switching on the circuit, you can see the bulb glows, that means a current flows, and you can see as current flows, the compass needle deflects. And when the switch is opened and the switch is in off state, the current stops and the compass needle again approaches to its initial value, or it is in the normal state. And here you can see when the switch is closed, compass needle is deflected, and we know well that the compass needle is deflected only by magnets or the magnetic field. So in this situation, the experiment verifies that when the current flows through the solenoidal coil, a magnetic field is produced by the coil like the one which is produced by a magnet, because of which the compass needle is deflected. So it verifies that when a current flows through a wire, it produces magnetic field. And in this experiment, we are accumulating the magnetic field to make it strong by making a solenoidal coil by winding the wire on the rod. If a single turn is used, obviously the deflection of needle will be less, as more turns are producing more field and a significant deflection can be seen in the compass needle. And here we can write this effect. The magnetic effect we are talking about was first observed by a physicist named H.C. Oersted and later it was known as Oersted law. In the next section, we'll discuss about Oersted law in detail.